Okay, so for this video, we're gonna go straight to the point. If you haven't watched or read Three Body Problem, just do it now, please. I read the book almost 10 years ago without knowing anything about the plot, and that was the best way, at least for me, to experience it, so I don't want to take that away from you. Three Body is, at its core, an incredible story from possibly the most imaginative writer alive right now, Cixin Liu, and it's worth experiencing in any form. If you have watched or seen it, or don't care about spoilers, then I'll invite you to the rest of the video where I'm going to share what I think. Long story short, the Netflix version of Three Body is an at times infuriating adaptation that misses the mark on some important things, but I desperately want it to get renewed and for this team to be able to tell the full story. I'll keep this critique short for the selfish reason that I'm in the middle of reading The Dark Forest right now, which is the second book in the trilogy, and I want to finish this video quickly and just get back to it. I'm going to be lazy on my editing for the same reason. My issues with the show are mostly centered on two things, writing and direction. The latter is the lesser of the two evils, so I'll touch on it quickly. There are some great moments here and there, but for the most part the direction here just feels uninspired. Like, the camera is always placed and the editing is always done in the most standard and kind of boring way. Not necessarily bad, but just never bold or surprising. This isn't the worst thing in the world, and it's absolutely subjective, but it becomes a problem in a story like Three Body because of just how out there the story gets and the scope of it. And what this does, I worry, is that as the show gets more and more high concept and out there, it's gonna put a lot of pressure on the CGI to make it believable. And that's expensive. If they had taken a more unconventional and artistic approach to the filmmaking, this wouldn't have been as much of a problem. You'd be able to communicate things symbolically, conceptually, without the CGI needing to be perfect. But as it stands, and just knowing how off the rails things will get from here, it's worrying. Now, let's get to the writing. This is definitely a step up from D&D's work in the last two seasons of Thrones, thank God, but there are moments here that just remind me it's run by the same people. My biggest problem is that, you know, I'm trying to say this without saying D&D aren't very smart, but they seem to have a hard time grasping the importance of logical consistency, I think is a nicer way to put it. And with Three Body, that's a big problem. The whole reason the book works is that Cixin Liu can convince you that as insane things get, it's all bound by reason and rationality and human nature, with just the necessary amount of suspension of disbelief. When you lose that, then the plot can feel silly. There are two major examples of this that I'll go into. First, the Judgment Day scene. In the book, Liu takes an excruciating amount of detail with a lot of spirited and intelligent back and forths to land on the eventual solution, and when they decide to slice up that ship with nanofibers, killing everyone aboard, you're convinced that this really is the only way to get the alien's hard drive from the ship without damaging it irreparably. The show instead just kind of glazes over this, skips over some of the most important rationale, which makes the scene where they murder a boat full of civilians, including a bunch of children, just bewildering. If you didn't read the book, I wouldn't blame you for just dropping it here and writing off the entire plot as ridiculous and stupid. It's giving Daenerys burning all of the civilians in King's Landing, and that's not good. The second example has to do with the Sophons and how they work. The central conflict with Trisolaris hinges on the fact that these particles allow the aliens to see and hear and understand everything humans are doing. But except for some visual trickery, they can't directly affect anything on Earth. This is the only thing that makes the battle winnable for humanity. And the fact the show makes this kind of fuzzy and unclear at the end, implying that they could crash a plane in that scene with Wade, if they don't fix this and clarify retroactively that, you know, that was just a hallucination, they need to make this extremely clear or else the rest of the show is going to feel like it's built on a plot hole. Why don't these aliens just crash all the planes and set off all our nukes, right? These are just two examples, but this tendency to play it loose on logic is sprinkled all over the first season Three Body Problem. Like that scene where Jack just straight up abandons Jin in the meeting with the ETO. Not only does his turn seem so abrupt, but to leave his friend with this shady group just feels irresponsible in a cold way that wasn't set up in Jack's character. I'll stop there because I don't want this video to get too long. Despite all of this, I need this show to get renewed. That's a testament to this incredible story written by one of the best storytellers around today, and all the best parts are still ahead of it. If they can improve on these flaws in future seasons, I think we would not only get a classic, but inspire more people to dream up stories like Three Body Problem, and inspire studios to bet on this kind of hard science fiction. I want to live in a future where Three Body becomes a mainstream success, because I think us fans of stories and worlds and imagination are all going to benefit from it. That's all for now. This is Quentonaut signing off. If you like this, please do subscribe. I'm a sci-fi writer making comics in the Philippines, an entrepreneur building and investing in media companies, and just a fan of stories in all forms. Your support means a lot, so I hope you enjoyed, and please take care of yourself. Bye.